So have you just got yourself a brand new iPhone 13 or a 13 mini, a 13 Pro or 13 Pro Max like I've got right here? And you want to know, how do I get to this home screen? How do I set up my iPhone to get to the screen? Well, today I'm going to give you a step-by-step guide in how to get to the screen. So first of all, congratulations on getting yourself an iPhone 13. They are an absolutely amazing iPhone. I've been playing around with my iPhone 13 Pro Max that I have right here, and I absolutely love it. And I'm sure you'll love your iPhone 13 as well. So today I'm going to show you a step-by-step guide on how to get to this home screen, if you don't know how, via using another Apple device like I've got right here. Or the other way I'm going to show you up is setting up an iPhone 13 from scratch with no apps and no data. And also, if you're brand new to Apple, the Apple ecosystem, I would recommend, first of all, making yourself an account online. As you can see here, it is really simple to do. And once you have done that, come back to this video and I'll show you how to do this guide. So first of all, let's do the step-by-step guide if you have another Apple device like we have right here. So let's begin, and then after that, we'll switch over in setting up an iPhone without another Apple device. So first of all, my apologies that you can see me in the screen here, but it's just a reflection of the light. But I'm going to turn on the screen here, and this should be the first screen that you should see when you get it out of the box, the hello in different languages coming up. Once you've got this showing, what you want to do is swipe up, select the language that you want to have the actual setup in. So I'm going to select English and set my country as United Kingdom. Now we have the quick start here, and this is if you do have another Apple device. So I have an iPhone 12 Pro Max, and as you can see here, it's saying to set up my new iPhone. So I'm going to click connect here, and as you can see, we've got some dots. Now what you have to do with your old kind of Apple device, using the camera, you have to get the dots sort of aligned up, and it will kind of start transferring your data over. So what I need to do next of all is just put my code in from my old Apple device. So I'm just going to pause the video while I just do this. And there we go. It's now saying setting up on my iPhone. Now, what you want to do is keep your old iPhone near. Do not take it away, put it in your pocket. Keep it near your new iPhone while all of this setup happens. Now, what will also happen is on your old iPhone or on your old Apple device, it doesn't have to be an iPhone, it can be an iPad or it could be an iPod Touch, for example, then basically this little window will tell you it's no longer needed, and we'll see that later on in the setup. But for the time being, this iPhone 13 is just activating, and it even says here, as you can see on the screen, this may take a few minutes to activate your iPhone. And there we go, it is now set up and ready to go. So the first thing it's asking to do is Face ID. So I'm going to quickly do Face ID, and you'll probably see my camera here. So I'm going to click Get Started, and there we go, you can see my face. And I'm just going to circle it around to put my face in. And then just do another scan for my Face ID. And there we go, it's all done and ready to go. So we're going to click Continue next, and just wait for the next bar to continue. And as you can see here, what I can either do is I can transfer all my data all from this old iPhone here, or I can download it from the cloud. Now I'm going to select the cloud option. So it says setting up your Apple ID. So it's just getting my details through and what getting all my cloud information onto this iPhone. And I'm just going to agree to the terms and conditions here. And there we go, on this next screen, we have everything ready to go. So we got all my app details, my settings, my connections, even with my Apple Watch, for example. I'm gonna click continue on. Now, what's gonna happen is that it's gonna pull down my backup. And also at the same time on my old kind of Apple device, I don't know if you can see this here, it's doing an updated backup to make sure I've got the most latest version. But while that's doing that, I'm gonna set up my debit cards and my credit cards in my wallet on my new iPhone 13. So I'm just gonna click continue here, and I will have to put in my kind of 3-digit code, so I'm gonna have to pause the video on it. But you can do the same on your debit card if you just wanna put in your codes as well. But I'm just gonna continue on for now, but I will pause the video in the next stage or so. So after the card was set up, the next thing to do is to do with sharing your data with Apple. So analytics, I'm going to share with Apple. My app data, I'm going to share as well. And as you can see, it's backing, it's going to pull down a backup. So I'm going to pull down my yesterday's backup onto my iPhone, and I'm going to leave this run. Now this will take a while to do, and depending on how big your backup is, it depends on how fast this will take to get onto your iPhone. Also, your internet speed is a big factor in this as well. So I'm just going to place this down for the moment, and then when it's done, I'm going to finish off the setup. But as you can see on my old Apple device here, you can see everything's ready. You can just basically come back to this phone and just basically just turn it off, and it's all done. So we're completely done on that phone. We don't need that one anymore, but I'm just going to leave the iCloud backup just to restore now, and I'll be back in a mo. Well, there we have it. The iPhone 13 has now set itself up. So basically it did do a restart during that time to pull the backup on, but if we just do an unlock here, as you can see, all the apps are coming down. It's asking me to do lots of sign-ins and stuff, but all my apps are being pulled down onto this phone, and everything is back to the way it should be. If you just leave this, everything will come along to it bit by bit by bit, depending on how fast your internet speed is. So, just quickly, this channel has just hit over 230,000 subscribers, which is absolutely amazing. And we did a giveaway of a MacBook Pro M1. Well, I've got you some great news, guys. We're doing another giveaway, and it is for this. It is for an iPad Pro M1 with 8 GB of RAM and 256 GB of storage. Now, anybody can enter in to win this giveaway around the world. It is an international giveaway. But all I want to know from you guys is basically, what Apple tech are you planning to buy in 2021? Or what other tech are you planning to buy if it's not going to be Apple tech? Write it down in the comments below, and make sure at the same time as well to subscribe to this channel and also hit that notification bell, because when we get over 260,000 subscribers, I'm going to be revealing who the winner is of this iPad Pro. So make sure you do that right now, because you'll want to know if you're going to be the lucky person to get your hands on this iPad Pro. Also at the same time as well, if you're enjoying this video so far, please make sure to press the like button. Well, let's get back to the video. Now, if you're brand new to Apple and you've just made yourself a brand new account, like I showed at the beginning of this video, or let's say you're coming over from Android for the first time, you've never been on Apple. So what you want to do this time is basically you want to open up your screen on the Hello page again, select the language and the country that you're from. So I'm going to select United Kingdom here, and you might have had the page before, it says English or whatever language you want to pick. But this time on this page, you want to select setup manually. Now what it'll ask you to do is connect to your Wi-Fi, what is close enough to you, and you do need Wi-Fi for this. So I'm just going to select my Wi-Fi and put my code in, but I'm going to pause the video while I do this. Once you put your Wi-Fi details in, it will register. And then after this, it will take a minute or two to activate your new iPhone. So I'm just going to leave this run for a moment, because like I said, it can take a minute to do. And then after this, we just want to accept on the data and privacy, and then we want to set up Face ID again. So again, you'll see my face behind the camera here. There I am. So I'm just going to move it a bit more closer. And there we go, I'm just going to rotate my head round, as you can see. And then it's going to do another scan again, do it the other way this time. And there we go, it's got my face captured. So just click continue, and then afterwards click continue again. And now this time it's going to ask us to set up a code. So I'm going to set up a code, but I'm going to choose a 4-digit code for me. But you can choose whatever option you want here. You can also choose an alphanumeric, a custom numeric code, or a 6-digit code. I'm having a 4-digit code. So I'm just going to pause the video while I put my code in and double confirm it. Once your code's in, you're ready to go on to the next step. And then this is the page now where, if you're brand new to Apple, like I said, you don't have another Apple device, you'll select the right option for you. So you can either basically restore from an iCloud backup like we did earlier on this video. We can restore from a Mac or a PC. And this is if you've done a backup of your Apple device on your Mac or your PC. It doesn't mean that you can set it up via your Mac or your PC. It means it's going to look for a backup. So do remember that. The other ways you can transfer directly from an iPhone. That was another option we had. You can move your data from Android. So if you're on a Samsung phone, a Xiaomi or Huawei or many other sort of phones out there, you can transfer from them. Or you can say set up brand new if you don't want to transfer any of your data over, or none of these options are applicable for you. So I'm actually going to select that option. So what we want to do next of all is put in our Apple ID and password, the one that we set up earlier right at the beginning of this video, or the ID that you might already have with Apple. Go and find those details out and put them into your iPhone. After this, we want to accept the terms and conditions by clicking agree. And again, it may take a few more minutes to update your iPhone. And again, it may take a minute or two to set up your iPhone. So we're saying that we're going to make this my own phone. So we don't want to change any of the settings here. We just want to click continue, but you can change some things if you did want to. So you can like change like how often your phone updates. By default, it's automatic, but you can change it to, let's say, a manual update. But you can also change things like with Siri, your appearance, screen time, loads of other bits and pieces if you want to edit them. But I'm going to click continue for now. And we put it into dark mode on my phone. And then after this, what you can also do is add on your debit card or credit cards if you want to do this. So it's remembered because I've logged in that I do have a debit card, and I'm going to add this to my Apple Pay. But I'm just going to press continue, put in my card details, and then after that, continue on with the setup, and I'll resume the video from there. After this has been completed, it shows you how to use Apple Pay, but I'm going to click continue. And then also we can share our data now with Apple for other bits and pieces like Siri, for example. I'm going to share that. And I'm also going to share my iPhone analytics and share with app developers as well, any crashes or any bugs with my apps that I'm running. And then after this, I can swipe up to get started. And now we're on the home page, but it's asking me for my wallet, if it wants to use my GPS, and I'm saying that's okay while using it. But as you can see, here we are on the main home screen, set up as a brand new iPhone user. So as you can see, either way, it was super easy to set up your iPhone 13 model, and all your apps should be downloading now, and you're ready to go and have fun with your brand new iPhone. So if you have enjoyed watching this video, because it's time to wrap it up now, please do press the like button, and also at the same time as well, if you want the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons, please also hit the subscribe button followed by the notification bell. Until next time guys, I will see you soon. Bye bye.